for Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light lives. I'll be home for Christmas. If only in my
they are so excited. I remember that feeling so clearly. I didn't think I could ever sleep. I remember pinching myself to stay awake so I could hear the reindeer's footsteps, you know? I wanted to believe it so badly. Why don't you turn the sound up? Look, it's coming down like crazy. You can hear it, can't you? When it gets deep like this, it just swallows up all the sound. And you feel like you've been wrapped up in the hands of a big, sweet, giant, white monster. Good monster. You're my Santa Claus. And our two elves? I'm having one of my euphoria attacks. I think I'm going to be terminally happy. You better watch out. It's catching. It's highly contagious. What's the matter? Just sleepy? Can we listen for a second? I won't stay up all night, I promise. Oh, God, I feel so sorry for Jeanette and Freddie sometimes. These things happen for a reason, I know, but I always think if something happened to us, I'd want them to raise the boys.
And on a tragic note this Christmas Eve, Martina Elavon, the Ohio woman that jogged from Maine to Southern California with a tiny doll under each arm in an effort to alert people everywhere to the plight of disabled children, is dead of a heart attack.
Oh. Age 42.
Sheldon?
What's the matter? Well, honey, it's just the news. Come on, it's not real. We'll turn it off, see? I'm here and everything's fine.
I took a contract out on your life.
What do you mean? Life insurance?
A contract on your life.
That is the sickest joke. I'm sorry.
In 5 minutes, a man is gonna break in downstairs. I'm sorry this is happening this way. It was a stupid solution. We should have talked it out.
It's Christmas Eve.
Run over to Jeanette. Tell her we had a fight. It doesn't matter. Wait. Here. I'll call you when he's gone.
I'm gonna sleep in the other bedroom.
Rachel!
You're hurting me!
This man is a professional! I can't take it back! Look. This is a .38. It's all planned to look like he broke in. I pulled this, and he killed you! You understand? A thief! An accident!
This is so mean!
You can't be here. He has his money.
anybody mind taking a little spin down here to the Arco station? At Route 3 and Carl Bluestein Boulevard? No, nothing like that. I just came outside. Isn't it? It's beautiful. Uh-huh. Listen. Tom took... It's so ridiculous. He took a contract out on my life. A contract? Uh-huh. Jeanette? No. I know I am. I'm a kidder, but... No.
Okay.
Paul, did you want to use the phone? Please, go right ahead. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. You need a lift?
No. Yes, no.
No problem.
No, thank you.
You're sure?
No, thank you. I mean, yes.
Come on.
Where are you headed? Some night.
Yes. Christmas. I love Christmas.
Yeah.
Maybe you should just drop me off up at the, Well, I can get off anywhere. Where do you live?
Springfield.
Springfield. The field of spring. Did you tell me your name?
Lloyd.
Lloyd.
Buffdalofty.
Buffdalofty. Isn't that an interesting name? I'm Mary Ellen Sissel.
Nice to meet you.
Is my maiden name. You have a family?
No. You?
No. Oh, This is just costume. I just wear this. See? Goodbye!
You and your husband have a fight or something?
I'm not married. You? You have a girlfriend.
Just Pootie.
Pootie. Pootie. My son does the cutest thing. I was married before. My son has custody. My father, My son is 4 and a half. My husband has custody. My father is dead. Well, there are two boys, but Jeremy's a year older. But Tom Jr. is always firing everybody, you know? If he doesn't like what you're doing, he'll say to his babysitter, who's usually my friend Jeanette, who can't have kids of her own because of this thing in her uterus. He'll say to Jeanette, you know, "You're fired, Jeanette," just because she wants to put him to bed or something. And just today, he fired me. On Christmas Eve, I said, "You're gonna fire your own mother?" "That's right," he said, "you're fired." So.
Now you're fired.
I'm fired. Lloyd?
Yeah?
You think we ever really know people? I mean, I know we know people, but...
You mean really?
But really?
You mean know them?
You think?
I don't know
either.
that your tree?
Be out in a sec.
Thank you. This is so Christmassy.
How about a rum toddy?
Great.
Coming right up.
This is so lovely.
Glad to have the company.
Hello. Rachel Mary Ellen. The Rachel is silent. Nice to meet you. This is so nice. I hope I'm not, you know, I feel... Actually, my house burned down, and Lloyd was kind enough to say I could stop...
Keep your face turned towards you so she can read your lips.
Oh, she's deaf. You're deaf, I'm sorry. Not that you're deaf, but, I love your house.
The one and only Pootie Poot Pooter. Mary Ellen Sizzler.
Oh, well, did you slip on the ice?
She's paraplegic.
Paraplegic? Oh, well, tell me, Pootie.
I'm just gonna go check on the toddies.
What kind of a name is that? Your name, it's so unusual. Pootie. Uh-huh. You know, I was just saying before to...
She talk your ear off?
Thank you.
Pooter Bear?
Aren't you gonna have any?
Never touch the stuff.
Cheers. Sure there isn't any poison in here? Isn't that beautiful the way you do that?
All right, everybody. Time to open the presents.
I'll watch. This'll be fun.
Merry Christmas from us.
But I didn't get anybody anything.
Go on.
I think this was meant for somebody else. This is so strange. Aren't you both so nice?
Like it?
Like it.
Okay. Who's next?
Okay, wait. Now, I'm sorry I didn't get a chance to wrap this, but... Merry Christmas. There. Isn't this fun?
She says you didn't have to do that.
Of course I didn't have to do that. You didn't have to ask a woman in her slippers to spend Christmas with you either. I could be a mass killer. I could be anybody. I could be anybody. Jeanette? Yes, Happy New Year.
Peter, how are you? Right now? Oh, I'm just, you know, I'm up at my cousin's. But tell me, what did you get? Of course I have a cousin. What do you mean? Everybody has cousins. Jeanette, do I sound fine? Listen, would you do me a favor? Will you look in on the boys for me when you get a chance? You will? No, everything's great. But, shoot, here comes my bus. Listen, Jeanette, they're gonna close the doors. I gotta run, but I appreciate it. Bye now. Hi, how was work?
Okay. Hungry?
No, but I'll cook. How's that? What would you like?
What do you make?
Whatever you want, just name it, it's yours.
Whatever we want.
Uh-huh.
Discussed it, and we both want you to stay here.
For dinner?
For as long as you like.
Oh, no, I couldn't. Thank you.
Why?
Well, I mean, I could, but I can't. Thank you very, very much.
Why?
That's very kind. It's because.
Because why?
Just because.
Because why?
Because I'd have to get a job. I have to get shoes. I can't just move in.
Why not?
Pootie, come on.
Tell me why.
Because
why?
This is the way children talk.
So?
So's your old man. Just because, that's all. I love you both so much. I do. Why are you doing this?
Because.
Where are we anyway? I mean it. Where is Springfield? Do you people even have identification? My mother may not even let me play with you. She's very fussy.
Springfield. If you lived here, you'd be home by now.
Look how big the world is. All in this book. I'd love to move in, you know that. I'd love to start my whole life all over again, right this second.
Why can't you?
Because I have to get a job.
People hear the name Hands Across the Sea. They think clinics, halfway houses, adult education, international relief effort. But just because we're a not-for-profit humanitarian foundation does not mean we get away with murder. Any of us. Trish Hammer, Mary Ellen Sisler.
Hi.
It means lots and 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 lots of work. Satisfying, but still work.
Uh-huh.
These are your insurance forms. Fill them out and give them to Mr. Seacon. Then ask Trish for some documents to process, and she'll get you started. Any other questions, come straight to me.
Okay.
So enjoy.
I will.
Thanks. Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
Great.
He seems nice.
going to need insurance. Do you know how... Never mind. I got it. So how was your Christmas?
Not a big fan of Christmas.
Parents put coal in your stocking one year?
My parents were killed when I was 6 months old.
Oh. I'm terribly sorry.
Why, you didn't do it.
No, I know. Oh, I thought I was getting shorter. Is there another chair, you know? This is fine. Mistress Eakins, do you know? I'm sorry, I'm supposed to take this to Mistress Eakins. Do you know where she is? Mistress Eakins? Do you know what I'm talking about? Mistress Eakins, I think he said.
Mr. Seekins.
Oh, I thought it was kind of a strange name. But mine is not to reason why. Mine is just... So do you have a family? Any kids or anything? No?
You like Trish?
Oh, sure. Now, she's in charge of what again?
All the budget. Payroll.
She seems kind of tight-lipped. How do you say that?
I don't know. Ask her.
Oh, come on.
Spell it.
You're just trying to turn me into a deaf girl. I know.
Got it? See what I tell you.
Oh. No. Hmm. Mm-mm. No.
What are you thinking?
You know.
No.
I don't know. Nothing much. Sorry.
Don't apologize. This is your time.
No, I know.
It's okay to sit here quietly.
Thanks.
She's nice. She talks. I talk. It's interesting.
Say we roast some marshmallows over the fireplace.
Great.
Okay.
I know. He can't know. It would break his heart. I'm sorry I didn't say anything about it before.
Oh, listen. You know.
When I lost the use of my legs, a friend drove me up here to see about this place where they work with the disabled. I remember the first time I ever saw Lloyd. He was working with a group of quadriplegics. I thought he was the most beautiful man I'd ever seen. A light shining out through his skin. But I knew I'd just be one more crippled dame as far as he was concerned, so I had my friend register me as deaf and disabled. I used to teach the hearing impaired. I thought if I were somehow needier than the rest, well, I found out soon enough that everybody gets special attention where Lloyd is concerned, but by then, it was too late. He was in love with me. With my honesty, he learned how to sign. He told me how he'd run away from a bad marriage and changed his name so he wouldn't have to pay child support. He got me a job at Hands Across the Sea. I couldn't bring myself to tell him that I'd had another name and another life, that I'd run away too, because I couldn't afford to pay all those bills after the accident. When he goes out, I babble. I talk back to the TV. I call people on the phone and say it's a wrong number, just to have a conversation. I'm afraid I'm gonna open my mouth to scream one day.
Keep it down in here. How's it going?
Great. It's pretty good.
Sorry, I can't hear you.
It's pretty good, I say.
Sorry, I still can't hear you.
It's pretty.
What?
Oh.
I believe in honesty. I believe in total honesty. Our whole marriage is based on that. He was the first person that ever really heard me, and I never even had to make a sound. You mustn't ever tell him.
No, are you kidding?
I've been thinking.
About?
Well, Christmas.
Go on.
Last Christmas, Christmas Eve. My husband and I were all tucked into bed, and the boys were in their beds, and everything seemed so perfect, you know? It was snowing, and... Well, actually, see, my father was allergic to dogs, so we never had one. And Tom doesn't like dogs either, so I didn't say anything about wanting one, but I was thinking about it, you know? And how you always see pictures of people on Christmas with a new puppy, and you never see them having to clean up the...
shit.
And suddenly I realized Tom's upset.
Your husband.
Tom, my husband. And I say, come on, be happy, it's Christmas. And he says he's taken a contract out on my life.
Oh.
I assume he's kidding. But in case he's not, right? So anyway, I wound up spending Christmas with this man I meet at the Arco station and his wife, who he says is his girlfriend because I think he's still married to the first wife. Anyway, Pooty, the new one, is crippled and deaf. She says, you know, it, with American Sign Language, which I actually go to all the trouble of learning, until suddenly she just turns to me and starts saying out loud how she has to pretend to be deaf to get the attention of this man we're both living with, who's run away and changed his name. And she's changed her name, and I've changed my name, and we're all working in the same place, and it's complicated.
When did you have this dream?
I'm going to have to take an early lunch today, Mary Ellen.
Oh, meeting a friend?
Well, you just hold down the fort.
Okay. Listen, any time you want to teach me anything about the computer or anything.
Oh, I think you've got more than enough to keep you busy, don't you?
Bye. In all these months, she's never shown me anything except how to keep track of this stupid storeroom.
Give her time.
There's something about her.
What do you mean?
Something she's hiding, or she never talks about her family or if she has kids. I bet there's something she's running away from. Some skeleton in her closet. I betcha.
What else have you and Pooty been discussing?
Nothing.
Anything you'd like to ask me personally?
Oh, I wasn't even thinking about that.
Yes, I left my family. No. They don't know where I am.
No, Lloyd.
No, I don't pay child support.
Please.
No. Bhaftalofty is not my real name. My real name is Boyd T. Theophilo. Anything else?
The past is irrelevant. It's something you wake up from.
I walked out on a woman with multiple sclerosis and two kids, one of them brain damaged, because I was too drunk to see him playing in the snow and ran over him with a snowblower. I left them with no way to feed themselves, ran as far away as I possibly could, changed my name,
took the cash I'd stolen from the kids' education fund and sent myself through school so that I could become a physical therapist and work with multiple sclerosis victims and the occasional brain-damaged child with motor skill difficulties, none of whom held the slightest interest for me except to remind me of what I could never escape as long as I live. The past is something you wake up to. It's a nightmare you wake up to every day. And let's see. I married a nice paraplegic deaf girl. And I don't drink anymore.
Well, why don't you pay back the money and say you're sorry?
It was $45,000.
So? People win that on game shows.
And here's your host, Tim Timko.
Thank you. Thank you. How did this game work?
Oh, that's right. It all comes back to me. Like last night. Who was that girl? It's good to be back. Let's see who's here.
Now remember, all you need is a mother, a wife, and the crazy idea that you could tell the difference. Does anybody want to play this thing? Well, what's it called? Your brother's wife?
No.
Your sister's best friend's mother-in-law?
No.
Your mother or your wife? Okay, wait, what have we here?
Oh, don't tell me. You folks are dressed as the solar system, aren't you?
That's right, Tim. How about that, huh?
And this looks like the planet Earth.
That's my mother, Tim.
Mother Earth. And I'll bet your world revolves around your son. And this must be...
Venus!
One touch of...
Your name, sir?
Lloyd.
You have a last name, Lloyd?
Boff to Lofty.
Well, you can say that again.
I should tell you, Tim, my mother is deaf, but my wife speaks sign language.
So she can translate. Well, come on up and play your mother or your wife. So, you're going to translate.
That's right, Tim.
Okay. You know the rules, Lloyd.
Give me a large Sprite, please.
So, well, okay. Take him away. Say goodbye, Lloyd.
Turn our lives to shit, and we eat it up. Explain that to me.
Tim, above the lines, we'll be playing for a grand cash total of $100,000.
Question number three.
If you could choose between your husband leaving you for another woman, or, as in Mom's case, her son leaving her for another mom? Guys, this question doesn't make any sense. I mean, what's he gonna do? Get another mother? Judges say fly with it. Okay, between you losing your husband to another woman or staying together, even if he doesn't love you.
In the wedding business.
Everybody loves somebody sometime. Everybody falls in love somehow. Something in your kiss just told me my sometime is now. Everybody finds somebody someplace. There's no telling where love may be.
Yeah, I don't like that song either.
Turn it up. Turn up the sound.
Lloyd Buffalofty from?
Springfield, Massachusetts.
Bakalovny, is that Polish?
Yes.
No, well, no. It's Welsh, actually.
Welsh and Polish. Well, good luck, because you're going to need it.
You got money on this game?
When asked if you reminded them of a paperclip or a ping pong ball, who said paperclip? And I quote, because you hold the family together.
My mother.
Right you are! What do you think you are, Lloyd?
For $20,000 and a chance to lose it all, which of the women in your life said, now let me get this straight, that they would rather lose you to another wife or mother, as the case may be, than to believe you to be unhappy in their home? Mother Earth or Venus de Milo? This is a tough one.
Both?
Both it is! Congratulations, Lloyd Bakalovny from Warsaw, Wales. Now's your chance to go home before you ruin your marriage.
We'll play.
Quiet, please. No help from our studio audience. For $100,000 in cash, Lloyd, we asked your mother and your wife, who does Lloyd love the most? Who said, keep breathing, you love your wife the most? Your mother, your wife, your mother and your wife. It could be both. Don't think too hard, Lloyd.
My mother.
Your mother! Oh, your mother!
For tickets to Your Mother or Your Wife, write your name and address on a postcard and mail it to Your Mother or Your Wife, Box 1224, New Hope Station, New York, New York, 10012.
In the dream, you pretend to be the wife, and Pootie pretends to be the mother.
Right. But that's just because you can't go on the show unless you have a mother and a wife. That's the way the game works. And Lloyd doesn't have a mother.
But Pootie is the wife.
Right. But we just thought it was easier to make her seem like the mother, since she wouldn't have to talk, and she's in a wheelchair. And it worked, so...
Rachel, we agreed that you don't have to talk about your parents until you feel you're ready. The loss of our parents is the greatest single trauma of our adult lives. But I also believe that our dreams are a way of telling us what we think we mustn't know.
Uh-huh.
Our secret wishes and fears written in code like an anagram, where the letters are all jumbled, but the secret is there. Why do you think you picked your mother or your wife?
Well, they picked us. We just sent in the postcards.
Whose dream are we discussing?
Nobody's. Oh, I'm sorry I didn't say that before. I thought that was part of the therapy, to talk about everything like it was a dream. It's not a dream. I was confused. I'm sorry. Sorry.
Would you like to see another therapist? Sometimes I think it's good to shop around, try different types of therapy. I honestly think it's time you looked at what it is in the loss of your parents makes it so difficult to share with me.
My mother was run over by a school bus when I was six. My father died of a heart attack the year I married Tom.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Rachel, did you ever wish, just wish as a little girl, that your mother would go away? Did you think you were responsible for what happened?
She was run over by a school bus.
And then what happened? You married Tom, and your father died.
Of a heart attack.
What is a heart attack? Isn't it a broken heart?
Trish?
Hmm? Oh, well, thank you.
Remember when I first started working here? You didn't really like me, did you? That's okay.
It's just that I don't warm up to people right away.
Oh, I know. But don't you think it was also because you didn't really think I was smart enough to handle anything too complicated? Well, I decided to show you otherwise, and I've been teaching myself about computers.
You have.
You mind? When you go to lunch. See? I learned how to call up the menu.
Mm-hmm.
And the file directory and everything. I even figured out about the separate accounts you have filed that don't appear on the main index.
Mm.
And I was trying to think what the password was, and I was fooling around with anagrams, and your name spells shirt, as I'm sure you know. And some of the math doesn't add up either. But before we open the presents, I want to say something. A year ago on Christmas Eve, you saved my life. And this year, you both taught me the true spirit of Christmas and giving. And I think you're just the best family anyone could ever ask for.
Who the hell is that?
Is Rachel Fitzsimmons here?
I'm sorry, there's no one here by that name.
Rachel?
Hey, wait a minute. Hey,
Rachel? Hey, Rachel? Rach?
Oh, hi, how have you been?
May I come in?
Sure. Lloyd? Tom. Tom Lloyd. Lloyd Pudi.
I found this by the door. It says it's from Santa.
Uh-huh. Oh.
It's nice to meet you all.
Pootie's deaf. And Tom's my husband.
How have you been, Rach?
Great. And you?
I saw you on TV.
Oh.
Yeah, I almost didn't recognize you. I thought maybe you'd remarried.
No.
So that was just
pretend.
TV, right? I brought you something. It's something you've always wanted. There isn't anything I can say, Rach.
That's okay. Why don't we have some of this champagne? Lloyd? Tom, it was very nice of you to bring champagne.
It was just sitting at the door.
Oh. Well, it was nice of someone then, wasn't it? What's this? Is this for me? You brought this.
The boys said that if I brought it, you might come home. They're at Jeanette and Freddie's right now.
Oh, how is Jeanette?
Everybody sends their love. We all miss you.
Oh, Tom.
You like him?
Oh, Oh, he's so sweet.
You don't ever have to clean up after him either.
Oh, look, everyone.
Cute. Oh. How about champagne? Everybody likes champagne?
Thanks.
Drink up.
Please come home, Rach. I feel like I'll die if you don't.
Oh, nobody's gonna die.
We're all gonna die.
Well, not right now, please. But cheers. Oh, God.
It's okay. I'll get another.
I'm sorry. Go right ahead, please. I'm sorry.
Cheers!
Is there a bathroom?
Oh!
Here you go.
Call the police? Lloyd, did we? Why didn't we call the police? Because they'll think we did it. Why would they think we did it? Because we didn't call the police. No, our fingerprints are on the bottle. So what?
What do you mean, so what?
Why do you have assumed names? What are you hiding? Nothing.
Where'd you get all that cash in $100 bills?
Oh, we won it on a game show.
What game show?
Your mother or your wife?
Is this your mother?
No.
Is this your wife?
Don't turn around. Look like you're having a good time. Uh-huh. Really? Oh, wow. Great. Tom brought the champagne, remember? No. It was sitting inside the door, he said. It wasn't Tom. Or he was lying. Maybe it was just a bad bottle.
Another giant gone before his time. Let's hope Santa left something special in New York.
Wait a minute. Santa? Satna. At Sna. At San. As Nat. Satna. Satan. Satan. Merry Christmas from Satan. Christ's birthday. Oh, that's horrible. Why is this happening? Why is it always Christmas? I love Christmas. I always used to say I wanted to live in Alaska because it snowed all year round and Santa was up there, so it must always be... Wait, can you read that, Lloyd? Springfield? Is that what it said? How can we be back in Springfield? Ohio! Springfield, Ohio! Thank you, God. I know we can be happy here. I just know we can. Who would ever think to look for us in Springfield, Ohio? Hello? Hello. Merry Christmas.
Chocolates.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. You don't have to pull back the covers. Thank you. You know, I didn't even know there was a Springfield, Ohio.
one in every state.
There is? Really? Well, thank you so much. Merry Christmas. Did you hear that? 50 Springfields. We don't have to stay here if we don't like. We can go anywhere, be anybody. We can go from Springfield to Springfield. How many people ever get a chance to do that in their whole lives? We're lucky to be alive. We could have had some of that champagne. Well, you don't drink, but... Let's pick new names. I'll be Jessie, and you can... No, wait. You be Jessie, and I'll be Mrs. Mancini.
Shut up. Shut the fuck up, please. Could we have one tiny moment of silence if it isn't too much to ask for, please?
I'm sorry.
What?
I said I'm sorry.
You know what I feel like having?
What?
You know what I really feel like having?
What?
You know what I really feel like having right now?
Piyoot, yit yit poo, yipo to. Toy po. Tu, poi. Poi.
Sounds like boy.
Two boy.
Two boys.
I have two boys.
His name.
I-N-G-O. I-N-G-O.
I-N-G-O. Ingo was his name.
Christmas dinner. I got you a present, too. Here. Merry Christmas. I couldn't think what else to get you. I'm sorry. They're just splits, so it's really only one bottle. Don't you want to listen to the news? It's the one night when they save up all the good news. Don't you want to hear it? Where's the knob? God, didn't she look like Trish, what's her name, from Hands Across the Sea? Lloyd, look. Look, my God.
Let me go.
Authorities refuse to comment, but local spokesmen say Ms. Hammers may have embezzled as much as $500,000 in her more than 20 years with the organization. Ann Lacker Holden spoke with Roy Miller, Assistant Vice President of Hands Across the Sea.
Boggles the mind. Very sweet girl.
I can't believe it!
We should all be wary of
Lloyd, it was Trish! No, he tried to poison us, and it wasn't Tom. It wasn't Tom at all. Wait, listen. Listen up.
Police are still looking for the two alleged accomplices in last year's Christmas killings in Springfield. We'll have more after
they
this
still
word.
Think we did it. We've got to go to the police because we didn't do it.
No, we didn't, and we can prove it, don't you see? Oh, thank you, thank you. Say goodbye to Springfield. Lloyd? Say goodbye.
I'm Sister Margaret. This is Connie, and this is Alexandra, and this is Camilla. What's your name? What's your name?
I can't see anything wrong with her hearing, and she's got a perfectly good set of pipes.
Maybe she's had some sort of trauma. Now, we've talked about the birth screen. It's a terrible shock to be torn away from the warm, beautiful, wet dark. And we're safe and sound with our mommy all around us. Till suddenly, cold steel tongs pinch our skin and pull us by the top of the head, and we don't want to go. No, you don't want to leave your home to somewhere that's unknown and cruel. And you're stinging now. And everything is breaking, and it makes you want to scream. Scream of the greatest tragedy of all time. And your mother's screaming, and now all the doctors are screaming, and everything is blinding you, and you're torn away, and They're hitting you. They're hitting you, and you open your eyes, and your mother is covered in blood, and you scream. Scream, scream. Come on, scream! Scream! For God's All right, we'll try it again. Listen to my voice. Let it be your guide as you drift off. You are floating peacefully, relaxed and perfect. Hit the father. Hit the father. Kill him!
In the summertime, they seem to be everywhere. But where do they go in the winter? It is in shelters like this one, in storefronts all over the city, where the needy, the cold, and hungry come for food and comfort. Sister, how many years have you been running this shelter?
Oh, well, it's not just me. The idea may have been mine back.
Hello.
10 years
may I help
ago.
You?
What kind of people stay here, and where do they all come from?
Oh, all over. Yeah, we have bank presidents, we have writers, you name it.
What brings them here?
Life's been reckless with these people, Maureen. Some more than others.
I see.
This is Eve. She came to us 6 years ago on Christmas Eve. You know, I don't know what she's seen or where she's been. She always has a smile on her face. Nightmares, Eve. Everybody. You made quite a noise. Does that mean you can talk? I have nightmares too, Eve. I remember what I did to someone once that I can never, never undo. I made a promise to the Lord that I would do anything if I could give just one person back their life. You may be that person, Eve. Come for a walk with me. Don't be afraid. There's nothing out there. Come on. See? We're capable of so much more than we dream. Becoming anything in the world. If we're willing to work and tell ourselves the truth. Hello. No!
yes. Say yes,
no!
Dean, you spoke.
No!
You spoke and I was wrong. There was someone and he was trying to hurt us. No. I don't know why. No. Oh, I was so wrong. Even you were right. Look at me. You spoke out loud and people heard you and I heard you and you heard you, Eve. If you can tell yourself what you want, you can have it. I swear to you. Oh, you want to know something? I used to drive a school bus. Yeah, that's right. I drove a school bus. Yeah. And how many bus drivers do you think become nuns? Who become social workers? None at all. Except the ones who do. Oh. Oh.
Vacation.
The Bahamas.
But that's where your mom and daddy are going. Where do you want to go? I mean, we're going on our own vacation, just you and me and Grandpa.
Where would you like?
All right. Close your eyes. Close them tight. Go on. Now I want you to imagine a place. The most beautiful place in all the world.
Don't open.
Your favorite time of year. The weather that gives you goosebumps. The right temperature. The right light in the sky. Everything just the way you like it.
Feet closed. I see you.
Now, imagine someone standing there in that very place who does all the things you like to do and has all the things you would ever like to have.
Within reason.
Now, imagine that that person in that wonderful, wonderful land is none other than...
Who?
Who do you think?
Guess.
Who?
Doctor?
Yes?
There's a student from the University of Alaska here to see you.
Oh.
He came by earlier and I told him to come back when you were through with your session.
Okay, fine. Thanks, Sharon. You can send him in. Oh.
The doctor will see you now.
Doctor?
Yeah. Sorry I kept you waiting.
Tom Fitzsimmons.
Won't you please have a seat, Tom? Please, anywhere. What's the problem? What can I do for you? Take your time. Just relax, Tom. What's the story?
I'm just trying to get some sleeping pills. They said to come see you.
Oh, I see.
You look really familiar.
I do.
Hey, you look really familiar. Where do I know you from?
Why do you think you're having trouble sleeping, Tom? Are you?
I know who you look like.
Your mother.
Yeah.
That's the transference, Tom. The patient projects an image.
It's incredible.
But you say you need something, is that right?
I've only seen pictures of her, but you really do. I mean, you're a lot older.
Well, of course.
Still, it's incredible.
Tom, what is all this about sleeping pills? Is that what you need?
Sort of.
Why?
Because I can't sleep. It's only for this week. Next week I should be fine, so it doesn't have to be very many.
Why is it just for this week?
Because.
Does it have something to do with Christmas?
You know, I really feel better now that we've talked. I really do. I don't think I need sleeping pills at all. It's incredible. Thank you.
Sit down.
I'm serious.
Sit down, Tom. What is it about Christmas? Some people think that the things you're afraid to think about are the things which eventually destroy you. And that if you talk about them, as painful as that is, it helps them to go away.
I'm not afraid to think about them.
What is it then? Are you afraid I won't believe you?
Maybe.
Why don't you try me?
My mother, the one, ran away on Christmas.
How old were you?
Four.
Go on.
And the next year, our father, you know, leaves us with friends, so he says, because he's going to bring our mother back.
You have brothers and sisters?
One brother, older. And instead, he gets killed.
Your
father. By, I probably had something to do.
I'm listening.
It may have had something to do with this whole scandal. Anyway, he died. They said our mother was involved, but they were never able to find her. And we were raised by these neighbors. They were really nice. And my brother disappeared when he was 14. We didn't hear anything. And he called and he said he found this woman who was going to pay. It was her. I guess he just freaked out. Got a gun and started shooting at people right around Christmas time. I don't know. They didn't convict him. He didn't hit anybody, but I just kind of thought I'd get away, you know? Alaska seemed like the place.
It is.
Well, not really. They have Christmas here, too.
Do you have, you have no memories of your mother, Tom?
No. I do one, but I don't know. Maybe I dreamed it.
What is the memory?
It's Christmas. And she's reaching up. She's putting something up.
On the tree.
Yeah, something. She's really, she's really happy. Everything's bright and she's all in this glow and she looks right at me and says, "How's that?"
How's that?
Yeah. Like that. And I just said it, you know.
What?
Lousy, you're fired. I was just kidding.
Of course.
It seems like that was the start of everything. It's like I hurt her feelings or something. She left. My father left, and my brother left. I just feel like if I could go back to that time, she would turn to me all lit up and say, "How's that?" And that's a beautiful mom, you know? It's like for one second I wanted to spoil everything. Everybody was too happy and I was too excited. But I take it back. I take it all back because I didn't mean it.
Of course you didn't mean it.
But I can't. I can't wake up. Just know if I could wake up, we'd all be there around the tree. My mom and dad would take care of me. I keep pinching myself, pinching.
Trying to wake up?
Yeah. I just keep wishing.
Yes.
For some place where
it's always Christmas.
Yeah. How'd you know that? Oh, I get it. Now you become my mother.
How's this time for you, Tom? Is this all right?
It's fine. We're through, yeah?
Tomorrow this time?
Yeah, fine.
And the day after?
Great. Wait, that's Christmas.
Would you rather not?
No. You work on Christmas?
I love my work. So, try to hold off on the sleeping pills for a while, all right?
Sure.
Tomorrow, then.
Great.
Tom? Sorry I kept you waiting.
No problem. Oh, right. I see. Well,
tomorrow. Evergreen Entertainment presents Mia Farrow in her best performance since Rosemary's Baby, with Scott Glenn, Mary-Louise Parker, and Tony Goldwyn, in a film that has critics giving 3 cheers. Rachel is having a very merry Christmas. Her husband has a surprise gift.
I took a contract out on your life.
That is the sickest joke.
This man is a professional.
She's spending the holiday.
You and your husband in a fight or something?
Cheers.
With some strange new friends.
Everybody gets special attention.
Do you people even have identification?
And she's been accused.
We're all gonna die.
Well, not right now, please.
Of a double murder.
Sure there isn't any poison in here?
Now, she's running for her life.
Police are still looking for accomplices in last year's Christmas killing.
With a jolly old hostage.
Oh, wow! Great!
And a plan to buy her way to freedom.
$45,000.
People win that on game shows.
Your mother or your wife!
This isn't Christmas.
Maybe she's had some sort of trauma.
This is a holiday in hell. Mia Farrow of Crimes and Misdemeanors, Miami Rhapsody, and Husbands and Wives. Scott Glenn of The Silence of the Lambs, Backdraft, and The Hunt for Red October. Mary-Louise Parker of Fried Green Tomatoes, Grand Canyon, and Boys on the Side. Tony Goldwyn of Ghost, The Pelican Brief, and star of the current hit Nixon. And Eileen Brennan of Private Benjamin. Reckless.
Why is this happening? I love Christmas.